Another one I put the pedal down to make some time. There's something good waiting down this road. I'm picking up whatever is mine. I'm running down a dream that never would come to me. Working on a mystery, going wherever it leads. Running down a dream. Yeah, I'm running down a dream that never would come to me. Working on a mystery, going wherever.
All it glitters is gold, and she's buying the stairway to heaven. When she gets there, she knows if the stores are all closed, with a word she can get what she came for. She's buying a stairway here. There's a sign on the wall, but she wants to be sure, 'cause you know sometimes words have to mean. In a tree by the brook, there's a songbird who sings. Sometimes all of our thoughts
we'll be right back. my dues. Time after time I've done my sentence, but committed no crime. And bad mistakes I've made a few. I've had my shells and kicked in my bed, but I've come through.
And the beats are gone.
And everything that goes with it, I thank you all. But it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure cruise. I consider it a challenge before the whole human race.
You were mine.
For a taste of things to come. anything was possible. Hit cruise control and rub my eyes. The last 3 days, the rain was unstoppable. It was always cold, no sunshine.
Till the end, we are the champions.
taken my bows and my curtain calls. You brought me fame and fortune and everything that goes with it. I thank you all, but it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure cruise. I consider it a challenge before the whole human race, and I ain't gonna lose. It's gonna be all the champions, my friends, and we'll keep on fighting till the end.
We are the champions, we are the champions, who can lose? We are the champions,
all the world.
Southwestern Buckeye League schools are really wondering this year, is the king wobbling? Valley View has ruled the SWBL in recent years, winners of 42 consecutive regular season games, but some think the Spartans may be ripe for the picking this year.
Valley View did lose a lot of players, but get with the program, son, and everything works out. As usual, the Spartans are loaded. Among the names to watch, Andy Keating, who's blossoming into one of the top quarterbacks in the state. And while All-Ohio running back Aaron Fott has taken his game to Stanford, Valley View's run and shoot may be even more lethal this year, since any one of three backs could get the ball.
There's not very many teams that can go undefeated five years in a row. And, you know, we've went undefeated 4 years in a row in league play and regular season. I think it's going to be real tough to do, but I'm hoping our kids are up for the challenge of it.
No one wants to end Valley View's reign more than Bellbrook. Lambasted by the Spartans in the final regular season game last year, the 8-2 Golden Eagles feel they've improved a lot.
Hope to continue their regular season win streak. The streak stands now at 42 games. The Spartans know the road ahead is full of tough challenges.
We've won 42 games second regular season. I mean, I feel everybody in our league wants to beat us. We're the top dogs and they want to take us down.
With all the things that you can do in the summer and everything, I think that maybe our passing game, it might be a little bit behind from where we've been in the past because our level of skill, but I think we'll be all right down the road.
Folks, we're going to wrap this up with a bang. More Gridiron highlights in the rest of your week two scores. Get your notepads out. Let's take you over to Valley View, where the Spartans were going to pound on Bellbrook big time tonight. Early in this football game, Valley View strikes for a score. Andy Keating to Josh Schmidt. We're all tied up at six apiece. Matt Four would score on a touchdown run, and Joel Phillips would also catch a Keating pass to make it 28-6 Spartans. Valley View comes back to just blast Bellbrook. Your final tonight at Valley View, 55-6. The Spartans are going to be for real again, to say the least. The Southwest tomorrow night features a couple of unbeaten teams. The Valley View Spartans, I mean, that's no big surprise. Jay Neiswanger and the boys always get out of the gate at 4-0. They have to play Northridge. Northridge is 4-0 as well, and Valley View knows it's going to have to be on top of its game, even though the Spartans are favored.
They're a pretty good team, but I think our defense is going to step it up. Offense should be pretty good. I think it'll be a good game, but I think we'll be able to take it.
For the Bellbrook game, they were supposed to give us a challenge. You know, I think Northridge is better. They got a lot of speed, and through tape, you know, they don't give up. They get after it, so it should be a good game.
Northridge, where the game of the week featured unbeaten Northridge against unbeaten and mighty Valley View. Steve McPherson looking a little bit, shall we say, well, he was ready to go. First quarter, Valley View keeping it on the ground. Andy Keating, this guy's tough. That's why he's going to West Virginia, a big gainer. Then, from the one-yard line, Matt Four plunging in. The two-point conversion was good. 8-0 Valley View. Late in the first quarter, Spartans on the move again. This time, Keating gets picked off in the end zone by Northridge. Doug Spear, you heard from him earlier this week, and this little fan, Surely she couldn't just bear to see that one. She must have been a Valley View supporter. The Polar Bears would take advantage. The rain picked up, and so did the running game. Mario Cora gets loose off the left side. A couple of plays later, Cora goes in for the score. The two-point conversion, though, was no good, and that would eventually cost Northridge this football game. A late safety wins it for Valley View. Your final, 16-14, but the Polar Bears gave the Spartans all they wanted, and then some. Definitely fitting for our game. Welcome back, everyone. You know, coming back to coach at your alma mater is a dream for a lot of high school players. West Root is no exception, but the timing for this former Valley View star really isn't what he anticipated. This young man has yet to reach his 20s, but he's already endured a lifetime of pain. Chris Kane has this special story in tonight's Kane's Corner.
At 19 years old, Wes Root was realizing a dream. He was playing football at an Ivy League school and living in New York City. Quite a change for a young man who grew up in Germantown. However, one day early last fall, that dream turned into a real-life nightmare.
Everything was looking real good, and all of a sudden, my life changes. I'm diagnosed with cancer, and I'm away in New York City, and that was basically it. I was just scared.
After he was diagnosed with Hodgkin's disease, Root underwent 35 painful radiation treatments on his stomach.
I just thought I was going to get through, and I think athletics is makes you a little bit tougher as far as stepping up when something bad like that happens to you.
With his football career on hold at Columbia University, Root is currently serving as a volunteer assistant for the Valley View football team.
Talk about a positive person. You know, if you have Hodgkin's disease and you come back, you beat it, and then you're out here coaching, you know, what else can you say about the kid?
With his cancer in remission, Wes is planning on returning to Columbia in January. His goal is to be back in the Lions starting lineup next fall.
It's going to be great because I'm going to know I'm back, and I'm going to know that cancer didn't beat me.
With this week's Kane's Corner, I'm
Valley View-Carlisle matchup. Carlisle had their hands full early. Valley View on the move. That's Jason Rieger taking off downfield 24 yards later. He is in for the touchdown. Valley View leads 14-0, but they weren't done yet. More Spartans on the loose after the standard cheerleader cutaway. Quarterback Andy Keating and a handoff to Matt Four. And Matt Four turns a huge run in, good for six. And then an extra point made it 7, 26-0 Valley View. Man, they were strong tonight, as usual. Carlisle didn't go away quietly. Quarterback Travis Martin puts it up. Chris Brown comes down with it, good for 35 yards, but not enough. The Spartan machine keeps cruising along. Tonight's final 40.
Yeah. You know, this is the first time in the history of grudge match someone has been losing this bad. Any comment on that?
I hope he picks the right team.
You don't think I should give him you guys for the sure win?
Nah, I wouldn't.
Just go all the way, go the whole season, and just pound it to him.
Yeah.
Kind of like you're going to do tonight to the Eagles.
Yeah.
Okay. Come on, buddy. You know, he wants to pick you, too. I don't think we both can take you.
Well, somebody's got to lose.
Jack, just the facts now. The Spartans have not lost a regular season game since 1991. They're on a 49-game winning streak, and gosh, I wonder who's going to win tonight.
Now, wait a minute.
Wait a minute, Book. I smell upset. And you know what you are suffering from?
What's that?
Overconfidence. Look out. Here comes Eaton. Well, Coach, I know you're worried about Valley View, but they're nothing compared to the Jack Jinx. I don't win very much a grudge match, but I'm going with you guys. Are you ready?
We were ready until we heard that, yes, sir.
Both of you have goose eggs in the loss column, but you want to keep it that way.
Right. It's going to be a super game. It's going to be a grudge match. I mean, Bellevue Eaton, it says it so.
They haven't lost a regular season game like since 1991.
Well, all good things come to an end sometimes. Had a lot more support this year than we've ever had before. We plan to make them happy.
Somewhere over the rainbow.
Cut, Jack. There's no pot of gold under that rainbow and no win either. Hey, Poop, pay no attention to that man behind the curtain because my Eaton Eagles are ready for a win. Jack, if you only had a brain, because my Spartans, Matt Four, goes in for 6 and then 70 yards for a 14-zip lead over your Eagles. Boop, but my Eagles got the heart as Tom Jones
It's not unusual.
Hey, stay on script. Oh, that's right, the Wizard of Oz thing. Uh-huh. Tom Jones goes in from 14 yards out. It's 14-6. Oh, and my Eagles also have Dunnoyed as Tom Jones finds Justin Berbigler for an 8-yard touchdown. It's 14-12. Jack, you're not in Kansas anymore, but Adam Schaefer is in the end zone with this 4-yard touchdown reception. Jack, you're melting. And then it's Bobby Johnson recovering the block punt for another score. Jack, as I walk down the yellow brick road to another win, the final, Valley View 39, Eaton 26.
Western Buckeye League, undefeated Valley View hosting Oakwood. Spartans up 14-3 at the half, but the Lumberjacks, there's no quitting those Lumberjacks. In the third quarter, Matt Schmidt makes it 14-9 with a 1-yard touchdown plunge. Jack made it 14-11 with the 2-point conversion. Aaron Baruti to David Kumer in the back of the zone. We got a ball game. Spartans were worried. There were some scary moments, though. Andy Keating here on the keeper. A nice run, but he is going to, oh, no. He lost the handle. Oakwood recovers. Finally, with 55 seconds left, Oakwood needs only a field goal, but they're still out of range. 4th-and-4 on the Spartans, 35. The halfback pass, Jeff Griever trying to find Aaron Baruti for the miracle play, but Jason Yates picks it up, wraps up the Southwestern Buckeye League title for the 5th consecutive year. Spartans go 10-0 with a 14-11 win.
All right. The Valley View Spartans, remember last year, they lost in the playoffs. This year they're trying to reverse all that, taking on Cincinnati Indian Hill. Spartans score first. Andy Keating finds Jason Rieger, 17-yard TD. It's 7-0. Valley View up 14-7, less than a minute in the first half when Indian Hill quarterback Josh Cooper fakes out Tony Bologna, our photographer, and the Spartans D. He goes 59 yards for a touchdown. Give him a 2-point conversion. That tied the game, 14 all at the half. But the second half, all Valley View. Spartans mean business. Second possession. Keating again to Kevin Collard. Quick slant or 35 yards later and right in.
Five seem to have a legitimate shot at winning it all. One of those, Jay Niswonger's Valley View Spartans, coming off a big win over Indian Hill a week ago. A game that saw the Spartans score 27 points in the second.
Night Division 4 action between Valley View and Cincinnati, Wyoming. The Spartans trying to advance to round 3 of the postseason. Sky 2 in the house down in Fairfield. Pick up the action, our name and lights. How about that? Spartans take it to him early, scoring the first 2 times down the field. Andy Keating from 4 yards out, 21-0 at the half, Valley View. Valley View's defense absolutely shut down Wyoming's star running back, Richard Hall. He had 280 yards last week. Chad Thompson, Adam Schaefer, and Mike Minga make him go through heck right there. Valley View made it 34-0 on this 3-yard carry by Matt Ford before giving up 2 touchdowns late in the fourth. The Spartans are regional champs after the 34-14 win. Here's some other scores.